There are a variety of treatment options for knee arthritis. Assuming that the knee arthritis is osteoarthritis versus some other type of arthritis, such as rheumatoid or other type of inflammatory arthritis, we can go in an algorithm. I like the following algorithm for knee arthritis treatment. One is very conservative with physical therapy. Next is any type of injection, of which there are different types. And if that fails, then surgery might be indicated. So for patients who have mild to moderate osteoarthritis, physical therapy can be very helpful. It'll be a combination of stretching exercises, strengthening, and balancing of the muscles in order to try to achieve pain relief and good function, including good motion. If that's not helpful, or if the pain is too great for the knee pain to work well with physical therapy, anti-inflammatory medications can be tried, Tylenol can be tried, and then the injections might be very helpful for temporary relief. So for the injections, there are a variety of types. One is cortisone, which will last a good 3 to 6 months once given. It's fairly safe. I wouldn't recommend taking cortisone shots more often than every 6 months or so, because it can damage the joint. There are gel shots. Gel shots are the generic term for things like hyaluronic acid, where we inject the acid into the knee. It changes the nitric oxide levels in the knee in order to decrease pain. That can be either given one shot or sometimes once a week for 3 different weeks. If that works well, which it works pretty well in mild to moderate arthritis, it can last for a good 6 to 12 months. After that, that gel shot might wear off a little bit, and then a second round can be given. Another form of injection is PRP. PRP stands for platelet-rich plasma. We draw the blood from the patient, take out the bad growth factors, use the good growth factors, and inject it into the knee joint. That's been promising, and that can hopefully last more than a year. And then the final injection that I would consider is stem cells. And I remove the stem cells from the hip joint in the bone marrow. It can be removed from the fat as well, and inject that into the knee. And that's even more promising than PRP. The downside of the PRP and the stem cells, unfortunately, is that it's not approved by insurance companies yet. If those things fail, or a patient's having mechanical symptoms, such as catching or locking or buckling or giving way in the knee, and they might have a meniscus tear on MRI, or they might have a loose body, then arthroscopic surgery might be a good option for that patient. It can work well. But for just pain and stiffness alone, I wouldn't recommend it. And then finally, the option of major surgery would be a knee replacement. And so while there are multiple options for treatment of knee arthritis, it's best to start by considering the conservative management before surgery.